Today, Sunday, 16th, 2018. The news headline: National conspiracy and 2019 election. The bringing of the imposter Jubril from somewhere in Sudan is a national conspiracy. Stop thinking it's about APC only. The powers that be in PDP are in this together with the lords of APC and the slave masters, the caliphate. The national silence and the media blackout that followed this obvious truth about an imposter masquerading as Muhammadu Buhari is a pointer to this fact. Have you ever seen a politician from any divide probing these things? They are just silent. The plan is to make Atiku president through PDP and then retire the imposter for good after he must have served out Buhari's tenure and ensured that there is no change of power. Though the resurrection of the IPOB leader, Mazinimdi Kanu, and his unmasking of the imposter has put some commotion in the house of APC. They are currently in dilemma. They are confused. Is it to hand over or not? If we hand over, are we still protected with many evidences against us flying around? These are questions they ask themselves. They are contemplating on holding on to power as they know they have all it takes to retain power. Forget the bragging of PDP and their supporters. They truly know that APC has all it takes to win a re-election. Ekiti and Oshun is still evergreen. They know that with APC, their PVC is useless. APC can still win this election if they want, and no one will talk as usual. But the question is, what happens after? Will the collaborators in PDP still maintain their silence? There is truly nothing like APC and PDP. They are one party. They are fooling the youths who torn themselves to shreds in supporting APC or PDP. The big man in APC and PDP understands that they are one big family. That's why they frolic from APC to PDP. Jubril has all it takes to win the election for Buhari. Atiku can also be president if the caliphate and the cabals handling Jubril decides a handover. But not without a complete agreement of protection. My sadness lies on the helpless youths whom in all sincerity thinks their salvation lies in the hands of politicians without ideology. The United States government has expressed fear that the Nigeria's general elections scheduled for 2019 are likely to be characterized by violence. It said the conduct of the elections could have significant consequences for the democratic trajectory of Nigeria, West Africa, and the entire continent. The U.S., however, said the public disturbance that the elections would cause might not be large-scale nationwide conflict but localized violence. The U.S. Assistant Secretary of State for the Bureau of African Affairs, Tibor Nagy, disclosed this in his presentation during the U.S. Congress hearing on Nigeria's forthcoming elections in Washington, D.C. on Thursday. The President of the Senate, Bukola Saraki, Vice Chairman, Senate Committee on Media and Public Affairs, Ben Murray Bruce, and the Chairman, House of Representatives Committee on Foreign Affairs, Nana Yukj, were present at the hearing titled, Nigeria at a Crossroads, the Upcoming Elections. Our correspondent obtained a copy of Nagy's speech on Friday. Nagy, who is a member of President Donald Trump's administration and his lead foreign policy advisor for Africa, said the Department of State agreed with the view that Nigeria's 2019 general elections would serve as a critical test. He said, "I can tell you from my impressions during my travels and my previous service in Nigeria that I fear there will be some violence around these elections, as has been the case with previous elections. I do not anticipate large-scale nationwide conflict, but rather localized violence. We are already seeing increased tensions and polarization as the election approaches. We assess that politicians are turning to narratives of identity politics in an attempt to improve their popularity, with potentially serious consequences for national unity. However, Nigeria's political system and society have weathered such tensions before." Nagy said the U.S. government took the risk of any loss of human life during the elections seriously. To this end, he said when he was in Nigeria, he asked officials from both major political parties to sign pledges that their candidates would conduct peaceful campaigns. He noted that the major candidates had now signed a peace pact. Rivers, Borno, Benue, Kano listed as hotspots. He listed states that might experience violence during the elections to include Rivers, Borno, Benue, Plateau, and Kano. He added, in assessing potential hotspots for violence, we look at places that are historically volatile around elections such as rivers and Borno states. We look at states that are currently tense, especially if state-level politics are contentious like those in Benue, Plateau, as well as those in high-stakes locations with large populations such as Kano. We regularly engage with civil society organizations working in these hotspots and support their peace-building efforts. USAID programs and our public diplomacy campaigns also support peace campaigns across the country, such as #VoteNotFight. Through our Yali Network Nigeria campaign, Nigerians have made over 10,000 pledges to boost voter participation, reject violence, and vote with integrity. On expectations and concerns, Nagy said the U.S. government was monitoring and messaging, both publicly and privately, to mitigate a few key areas of risk that could jeopardize a free and fair process. He listed the areas of concerns to include potential attacks on the legitimacy of the Independent National Electoral Commission and the electoral process for political gain, intimidation and partisanship by security forces, and heightened insecurity, terrorist attacks on electoral institutions, or violence towards voters, observers, or electoral officials. Others are inability of large numbers of internally displaced persons or persons with disabilities to vote, voter suppression, the use of armed gangs for voter intimidation, as well as widespread vote buying that challenges the integrity of the electoral process. According to him, the U.S. government will be watching closely for instigators of violence or those attempting to undermine the democratic process. He added that the U.S. was helping Nigeria to strengthen its democratic institutions and processes through diplomacy and robust public engagement. While saying that the U.S. does not support any candidate, he said the government supports a democratic process that is free, fair, transparent, peaceful, and reflects the will of the Nigerian people. Nagy said only Nigerians could determine lasting solutions and a path forward toward peace and stability. 2019 will be a significant year for Nigerian democracy. It has been 20 years since the country returned to democratic rule, and this election's youngest voters have never known a Nigeria without democracy, he added. Buhari is the one promoting violence cup. However, the All Progressives Congress, the People's Democratic Party and the Coalition of United Political Parties have reacted to the development. The first national spokesperson of the cup, Imoyegach Nair, in an interview with Saturday Punch said the U.S. government was 100% correct in its fear of possible outbreak of violence. He, however, claimed that President Muhammadu Buhari was the one promoting violence by his actions, inactions and body language. He said, "The American government is 100% right in its assertion. President Buhari is the one that laid the foundation for violence by not signing the Electoral Act, amended, bill that would have ensured credible elections. The president is promoting violence by giving an illegal extension of tenure to a rampaging inspector general of police who has been behaving like an opposition member. Buhari is encouraging violence by inviting security chiefs to the inauguration of his re-election document at a time insurgents were killing our soldiers on the battlefield." Also, the PDP said the ruling APC and Buhari should be held responsible if there is any crisis in the country before, during and after the elections. The party said that actions, words and attitudes of the ruling party and the president were not indicating that the federal government and the Independent National Electoral Commission were ready to conduct credible elections. The party's national chairman, Uch Secondus, who spoke with one of our correspondents, therefore appealed to Nigerians and the international community to pay attention to happenings in the country ahead of the elections. Secondus said, "We are aware that the federal government and the APC are jittery over the reduced popularity of the president and his acceptability by Nigerians as a result of poor performance of President Buhari." The National Publicity Secretary of the APC, Lanarisa Anilu, said the ruling party aligned with the fears expressed by the U.S. government. But he attributed the possible cause of electoral violence to what he described as the worrisome signals from the opposition PDP. He claimed that the PDP's presidential candidate, Atiku Abubakar, had attempted to avoid signing the peace agreement designed by the National Peace Committee before he was put under pressure to do so. Issa Onilu said, "We align with the concern raised. It is a major concern to the federal government and the APC. We will do our best to provide a conducive environment for the elections." Nasrel Rufai, governor of Kaduna, says he will sue Paul Enich, pictured, senior pastor of Dunamis International Gospel Center, DIGC, over an alleged incitement. El Rufai said this on Thursday when Lai Mohammed, Minister of Information and Culture, paid him a visit in Kaduna. Over 50 people, including a traditional ruler, were killed in a religious conflict in Kaduna in October. Reacting to the development in a video clip that surfaced online, Enish had said the governor knew about the abduction and death of Maiwadi Galadima, paramount ruler of Adur chiefdom, because he invited him. The pastor said he was told that there was a move by the state government to bring all chiefdom under an emirate system, but Galadima rejected. But El Rufai said he has never invited any chief except when they write that they want to see him. The governor said he could depose any traditional ruler or abolish any chiefdom in the state under the law. "The recent crisis we had in Kaduna metropolis in Kasuwan Mugani was largely as a result of hate speech. The second round of crisis was because rumors started circulating that the abducted chief of Agata had been killed, and within an hour 22 people were killed, and it was totally false," he said. "By the time you create a lie that this the case of 22 people, consequences will follow, and even though the ransom was paid and he was free before he got to 3 Road, the kidnappers shot and killed him." What was the story? The story circulating was that I invited the chief to a meeting and told him that his chiefdom will become an emirate, and he disagreed with me, and when he was abducted, it was implied that I arranged the abduction. This is what started the crisis, and it is totally false. I have never invited any chief except when they write to see me. I can depose him. Why will I threaten him? I can abolish his chiefdom or emirate under the law." But this was the story circulating, and it raised tension and many people were killed. "The program you launched against fake news is commendable and should be sustained. There was a clip going round, a pastor in Abuja that said I was the one that arranged the abduction and murder of the Agam of Kucha. I have filed a complaint to the IG. We intend to bring him to Kaduna to try him." "The clip was circulated in Kaduna and he is in Abuja. We will get him. We know the agents of this kind of careless statements, and what is most unfortunate is that the guiltiest people that we assume should be responsible, pastors, imams and very important people in the society." He described fake news and hate speech as fundamental problems confronting the society. "It is not only the president that was said to be cloned. I am also someone from Mali. Somebody went to my Wikipedia page and changed my birthplace to Bamako, Mali. That the real El Rufai died when he went on exile in 2009, the governor said. "These things are becoming common. You have a whole range of gullible people. We must do something, otherwise we are all in danger." River State Governor Nizam Isinwowike has declared that any attempt to rig the 2019 elections in the state will be met with very stiff resistance. Governor Wike also declared that aside negative assurances that there will be the rigging option, APC Rivers State wouldn't have attempted to field candidates for the 2019 general election. The governor, who spoke during an interview at the Government House Port Harcourt on Friday, said that it is incumbent on the security agencies and INEC to be impartial. He said, "We want free and fair elections. We are therefore prepared to resist rigging. This is a solemn responsibility. Just take that as a bank draft. The only way forward is for the votes of the people to count. It is important that the security agencies must not only be seen to be neutral, they must be neutral." The governor added, "If not for the expectation to rig, there is no way that the APC will contemplate sponsoring candidates in Rivers State. All the hope they have is in rigging through the security forces. If they attempt to rig, there will certainly be resistance." The governor said that he is certain of a second term because his projects are scattered across the state and he has governed in line with his contract with the people. "When you put all our projects together, everybody is satisfied that we have done well enough to merit a second term. The projects that earned me the title Mr. Projects speak for themselves." The vice president who conferred that name on me went beyond politics because of what he saw on ground. There is no local government area where we don't have projects. We made promises and we have fulfilled the promises, he said. He said that APC federal government has no meaningful projects on ground in Rivers State. The governor noted that the International Departure Terminal commissioned by President Muhammadu Buhari was over 79% completed by the Jonathan administration, while funding was set aside through a loan. The good thing that will happen in 2019 is for the PDP to win the elections. No Nigerian who wants to better his life will want the APC to win, he said. Governor Wike said that he is still speechless that President Muhammadu Buhari refused to sign the amended Electoral Act to strengthen the democratic process. On security, Governor Wike noted that he is happy that issue of cultism has reduced fundamentally across the state. He said the killing of Don Wani and the signing of anti-kidnapping and anti-cultism laws have helped in ensuring that criminals are checked. Commenting on the crisis in Rivers APC, Governor Wike said that though it is not his business, it is obvious that it is a fallout of the impunity perpetrated by the Minister of Transportation. He said that whatever the outcome, the PDP in the state will emerge victorious as it has effectively used the mandate of the Rivers people.